I'm here in Eindhoven, the Netherlands, at the Pieter van der Hogeband Swim Stadium to interview Dutch Olympic swimmer Ranomi Kromowidjojo. She has already won gold at the Olympic Games in Beijing in 2008. She's a world champion, and now she's preparing for the Olympic Games in London. I'm going to ask her how she trains for that and what inspires her. How did it all start?
I was born and raised in Groningen, in the north of the Netherlands. And I live with my mom and dad and my brother. And as a young child, I loved swimming. And when I was 3 years old, I jumped into the water. And that was the moment my mother thought she needs to go on swimming lessons. And at age four, I started with swimming lessons. And I moved swimming and I was really happy and I enjoyed swimming. And
you had talent?
Yeah, I was talented.
When did you discover that there was a little bit more talent than the average?
By myself, I didn't notice I was a good swimmer. I just had fun, it makes me happy. And at age 14, 15, when I swam with the European Junior Championships and I won medals, I thought maybe this is something I can achieve something great, and it's not only swimming for fun, but swimming to achieve something great. And now I'm a professional swimmer. I wake up at 7 in the morning, then I have breakfast and I go to the pool. The morning workout starts at 8:30 till 10:30. After the swimming practice, we go to the gym and we have another workout like an hour with strength and conditioning training. After that workout, I go home, having lunch and rest some. And then in the evening, I go to the pool again and have training from 5 to 7.
So it's a full day of swimming.
Yeah.
And in between, there's a lot of relaxing.
Yeah, and between the practices, it's a lot of resting. I take a nap every noon and I relax and recover from the practice. And I feel if I do a nap, like only 30 minutes in the noon, I feel a lot better in the evening and the workout is a lot better. If I don't sleep, it's not like I feel terrible, but I feel better when I sleep.
I like it too. So London 2012, it's upcoming. Are you ready?
I'm not ready yet, but I feel great. And I feel really strong and I'm getting prepared for the best race of my life. The best prize to win is the Olympic medal in swimming. So all the other prizes are really great and fantastic, but the best medal is the best prize to win a medal. My grandmother inspires me a lot. She taught me how to swim. And I think without her, I wouldn't even be a swimmer.
What keeps you focused and disciplined every day to do that tough schedule? What is it? Is it that gold medal?
It's the gold medal, but I think the most important thing is I like to swim. And I started with swimming because I like to swim. And I swim every day because I like it. And deep inside me there's a drive and something that makes me want to win. And of course, if you win medals or become the best swimmer, it gives a lot of happiness and confidence. But I think knowing you like something, you like to do something, is the important thing.
What do you eat to stay fit? What's your diet like?
We don't have a diet. It's not like we're not allowed to eat French fries or soft drinks or chocolate bars, but it's more like it's a combination of good food, healthy food, not too much fat, not too much sugar, but we train a lot, so we need to have a lot of food.
Yeah, a lot of energy.
Yeah.
Do you take any vitamins or anything that you say, that's my favorite food, and if I eat that, that makes me feel amazing?
No, I don't have a secret food something, but I think I use everyday vitamins, multivitamins, and in the winter I get vitamin D, And I feel it helps vitamin D to stay fit and stay strong, and even in winter stay happy and don't get a winter
depression.
Depression. It's a secret that you can train as hard as you want, as hard as you can, but if it's in your mind it's not good, you never can be the fastest in swimming or in any sports.
Yeah. What are your thoughts about organic versus conventional meat?
I think as an athlete it doesn't matter that much if we eat organic chicken or conventional chicken, but for me as a person, I feel better to eat organic food, chicken.
To organize your life, we have a lot of models, and we all talk about fashion a lot. Do you like fashion?
I like fashion. I like to read the Vogue and the Elle. I think I'm one of the few athletes or one of the few swimmers who is interested in other things than swimming. I love to shop.
Or what clothes? Like, what do you like to wear? High heels?
No.
Why not?
No, I don't like. I like high heels. Of course, I like high heels, but I get a lot of trouble with my feet, with my ankles, and pain in the back.
After your career, you can walk in high heels as much as
for sure.
Do you have anybody in fashion world that you admire, that you like?
No, there are a lot of women I admire for their style, but I think there are not that much women who have their own style.
Copycats.
Indeed, yeah.
So how do you stay original?
Oh, I'm not original. I when I'm not wearing swimming suits or sports outfits, I like to dress up and be pretty, be nice, as every other girl.
You're in a pool the whole day, basically. The chlorine, just water on your skin. Is there any like secret beauty regimen that you have?
Just listen to your skin and to your hair. I think the chlorine is really bad for your hair, and we are like 4 hours a day in a pool, but on the other side we swim with a swim cap, and if I use too much products in my hair, the swim cap will go off. So it's a little bit of a half of everything, not too much products in the hair, but also I don't want to look like terrible, so I need to use a lot of conditioner and creams and stuff.
Do you care about your looks when you're swimming, or is it really you're only focused on getting, or are you like, we know other swimmers like Inge de Bruin, for instance, who really cared about her appearance. Is that for you important, the way you look, or?
Yes, it's important, but I think the most important thing is to swim fast and to become the fastest swimmer. But if you can look a little bit more beautiful, why not?
What do you hope the future will bring you?
Well, now I'm fully focused on London, and after the Olympics, I think it's one big question mark. There are a lot of things I like.
Fashion or beauty, yeah. Or your own swimming pool. Or
no, and I think if I quit swimming, I will never be a swimming teacher or coach or anything like that. It's
motivational speaker, maybe?
Maybe, but I think a motivational speaker is for not for the rest of my life. Maybe after the Olympics, a year or a year or two.
So Ranomi, thank you so much for your time. We wish you a lot of luck in London, and I want to give you a present from Organize Your Life. It's a 100% biodegradable mug made of corn plastic, and I hope you can drink a lot of tea and English tea.
I will use it, definitely. I will use it in London. Thanks.
You.